Hey folks, Raf from Defang here, and I got access to Kiro. I downloaded it basically as soon as it was announced, and I hear there's a wait list now, but I've got it. So let's give it a shot with Defang. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do is set up the Defang MCP server for Kiro. So to do that, you'll do Defang MCP setup client Kiro. When you do that, you see you'll be able to open this file here, and the Defang MCP server has been added. Now keep in mind there's this workspace config here. We're going to take a look at that later. But in the meantime, let's get into it. Okay, so I'm going to use the same prompt that I used with Windsurf and Cursor and VS Code with Copilot. So, quick clarification about this prompt. What it is a Flask application that generates open graph images. So we're going to have it create a PNG with some text that we can pass as a query string in the appropriate format for those open graph images. So let's go. It is pretty neat, this spec-driven vibe coding flow. This looks pretty good to me. Yes, the requirements look good. Let's move to the design phase. This looks good to me. It's funny, with the other ones, I didn't get anything like this. So there's nothing to read through, like what this eventually outputted system would look like. But this is kind of neat. I like the workflow. Yeah. I think that looks good. All right, move to implementation plan. So this task list looks really good to me. Honestly, for what we're trying to build here, it seems overkill, but in other contexts, I think this would be really valuable and really useful. So let's give it a shot. Finalize task list. The one problem I see here is that it's suggesting that I have to do each task one at a time. I'm going to try and ask it to just work through all the tasks because it shouldn't take that long to get it done. So we'll see what happens. I'll give it a shot. Maybe it works, maybe it doesn't. Requirements look like they make sense to me. Okay, so it actually did a really good job. I'd say of all of the vibe coding tools that I've used, this feels the most production ready, maybe a little bit enterprisey. Let's go ahead and try and get this up and running with Defang. Cool, it's deploying. We'll see what happens. This is cool. So it has the URLs available. We can see the current status. Some of the other tools tried to repeatedly check the status. I think this actually kind of makes more sense. Just let it go. Here we can see it's going ahead and deploying. And in theory, it should be done fairly soon. This is a good sign. Looks like Gunicorn is up and running. Response 200. I like it. It'll just need a few more health checks probably before it's marked as healthy. Okay, it's healthy. Let's ask Kiro to check in on it. What I'm hoping here is that it'll generate a command. Oh yeah, it'll probably check in on the service first. I hope it generates a command to actually create an image by hitting our endpoint. Cool, this is what I was looking for. So it hit the health check endpoint. Now it's going to try and generate an image. So I tried to visit the URL that it generated here, and that works fine. Okay, this time it worked fine. I feel like there's a tool calling issue there. You can see the image, looks great. Error handling is working nicely. Cool. So everything deployed nicely with Defang. I want a green gradient instead of a purple one, so let's see what happens. Cool. It worked. I'm curious to see if it'll fully test it, if it's gonna check for the green. It is checking. Very neat. Super cool. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is I wanna deploy this to an AWS account. So I'm going to head over to my MCP config, and you'll see you can switch back and forth between a user config and a workspace config. Some of this stuff might have changed a little bit, but what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna remove this from my user config. I'll tell you a little bit about why in a sec. I'm gonna head over to workspace config. I'll paste that in. And in here, I'm going to add env, and I will say Defang provider is AWS, and AWS profile is Defang lab, which is an AWS account I wanna use to deploy to. So the reason I'm doing it in a workspace config, so that's actually gonna be stored with my project right over here, is because you might wanna switch AWS profiles from one project to another. So in here, AWS profile, Defang lab, I know that this project is going to deploy to the AWS account associated with that profile. Okay, before we actually run this deployment, I just want to open up this Docker Compose file so you get a sense of what we're actually going to be deploying. It's going to build the Docker file, and it will set up an ECS cluster with this open graph generator service, which will run with port 8000 exposed to the internet. It's going to set this environment variable for the container running in the task for that service. It's going to set up health checks, and that's pretty much it. So let's go. Okay, I'm just going to tell it, hey, I've updated Defang config 2.2 and AWS account. Can you deploy again? So you can see that it has kicked off and we have an ID for the deployment. This might give us a little status update. Failed to get services. That's probably because they don't exist yet. In AWS, you can see that I do actually have a task running. So now it's running. Let's check the logs. Cool. So you can see it is building and deploying our project now. And here you can see my cluster has been created. And in a minute or two, we should see our task show up. There we go. The task has already shown up. It's not running yet. Okay, so we can see here in the build logs that it has completed the deployment. Update succeeded. Let's go back to our clusters. And here we can see Defang Kiro Vibe deploy. We have one task up and running. Excellent. I tried to call this earlier, probably a little too early. Please check again the service status. Excellent. So you can see here, Kiro has given me a URL that I can use. So let's give that a shot. We'll head over here. And there we go. Here is the running app in my AWS account. Text, it works. Excellent. So today we saw how we could vibe code our way to an open graph image generator with Kiro, how we can deploy it to the Defang Playground, and most importantly, how we can get it up and running super easily in our own AWS infrastructure. So I say vibe coding because we are still just giving natural language to an LLM and getting some code out of it at the end. But I think this new mode of vibe coding, this spec-driven vibe coding workflow, is really going to be a game changer. On some level, we've already seen that used as techniques. You set a system prompt saying always document, always create checklists, but it really feels like Kiro is formalizing that process and turning it into something that works much more tightly with the way that they've put this system together. And I think we can see that the results that come out the other end are actually a lot better. So I'm very excited to see where that goes. Okay, so that's it. I think this demo to me really shows the power of working with a tool like Kiro and Defang in tandem. You can just ask it to make updates to your code. It's really detailed in how it approaches these tasks and how it breaks them down. I was very impressed by the fact that it went in and actually downloaded the image from the endpoint deployed with Defang and double checked that it actually was outputting what it was supposed to be outputting. One thing that I want to highlight is that while we are integrating with LLMs and these vibe coding flows, everything that Defang generates is based on rules in our code. So none of your infrastructure is left to chance. It's all based off of industry best practices, based off of your compose file, your cloud provider, so that you get the best, most secure, most scalable deployments without leaving things up to chance. If you deploy anything with Defang, we would love to see it. Shoot us a message, drop something in the comments. We're always excited to see what people are deploying with our tools. So thanks, and I'll see you in the next one. See ya.